While there has always been interest to reintroduce new passenger rail services in Western Canada, including a commercial proposal to introduce high-speed rail between Calgary and Edmonton, another project has attracted a lot of attention for many years and is now seen as a priority by the province of Alberta, the Banff-Calgary train. As the name implies, this new route would connect the city of Calgary with Banff National Park, a World Heritage Site renowned for its breathtaking mountain landscapes, pristine lakes, and abundant wildlife. Currently, visitors to the national park need to either drive or take one of the many bus services that connect the national park and its town to Calgary. While the project is now promoted by a private entity, the origins of the project also involve plans for it to be government-owned. In 2019, Lyricon Capital, a Banff holding company that owns the Norquay Ski Resort and Banff Train Station lands, approached the Canadian Infrastructure Bank and the Government of Alberta to establish a public-private partnership to refine and develop the project. This ultimately led to a Canadian Infrastructure Bank-funded study in 2020 to evaluate the segment between downtown Calgary and the Calgary International Airport, allowing the project to enter its development phase in 2021. Further agreements were also reached with the Town of Banff, Canadian Pacific, the Government of Alberta, and a 50% funding commitment from the Canadian Infrastructure Bank to further advance the project in its design phase. CDPQ's plenary group became co-developer of the program in 2022, which led to enhancements and refinements to the project design. Since then, the Government of Alberta reaffirmed their support for the project, providing additional funds for the development of a regional transit hub at Calgary International Airport, where it would connect with future extensions to the Blue and Green Line, as well as the proposed Calgary and Edmonton high-speed train. While most people think of it as only a tourist train, the business case for the project also relies on attracting commuters along the corridor. As such, the line would operate between Calgary International Airport and the Banff Railway Station, with intermediate stops in downtown Calgary, Keith, Cochrane, Morley, and Canmore. It would operate along the existing Canadian Pacific Corridor on dedicated tracks along the 150-kilometer distance. Travel times are expected to be under 2 hours. As the train service would serve both commuters and tourists, the schedule and nature of services will be tailored to attract both groups with frequent trains all the way to Banff, though the downtown Calgary to the airport service would operate every 10 minutes. Once it opens, Lyricon and Plenary expects to capture 20% of all travelers to the national park, approximately 2.4 million passengers per year based on their 2022 estimate. In fact, most of the ridership is expected to occur between downtown Calgary and the airport, representing 9.4 million riders a year. Nonetheless, fares are expected to cover entire operational costs and offer capital cost recovery. While the Government of Alberta initially refused to support the project, as most of the financial risks would have been borne by the province at that time, the current subsidy model would be capped to a maximum of $30 million per year, with all other risks covered by the consortium. The latest cost estimate is around $1.5 billion as of 2022. The plan initially called for diesel-electric multiple-unit train sets, similar in size and style to the ones operated in Europe on regional lines. In fact, earlier renders showed Bombardier Talent train sets, the same type that were used in Ottawa for the original Trillium line. Electrification was not seen as viable in downtown Calgary, as the Canadian Pacific Mainline is not sufficiently large to support the additional equipment and tracks for electric operation. In August 2022, the project was updated to include the use of hydrogen-powered train sets, which would reduce CO2 emissions considerably while compared with diesel operations. While no decision has yet been made for the rolling stock, the Corridia Island, which is currently being trialed on the Train de Charlevoix, or the Stadler Flirt H2, were identified as the likely choices. It is likely that an order for rolling stock will be made once the project progresses to the realization step. Some parts of the design works and funding need to be finalized. The proponent believed the line could operate within 3 to 4 years from final approval and funding. At the time of writing this video, no such update has been provided on the timeline, though we can extrapolate that, should approval be obtained, the line could start operating in 2026. We are looking forward to the construction to start, as it will provide a decarbonized option for tourists and commuters in the Calgary metropolitan area. In the meantime, make sure to subscribe to Railfans Canada so you do not miss our future videos and updates on projects throughout Canada.